Somebody shout Jesus. Come on, shout Jesus in the room. We know what the power is.
Welcome to this Wednesday midweek service. I'm your host here, Apostle Lloyd Gangara. Let me take this opportunity to greet you. A very glorious evening to you. I trust you are well, wherever you are connecting from. It's my pleasure to be coming to you this evening. I trust God is gonna do something great today through His Word, and I have no doubt you're going to be blessed. Let me just pray. Father, thank you so much for this opportunity to share and to hear your word. Lord God, let your word go forth with power and so much grace to heal, to deliver, to save, to bless and encourage somebody. We thank you and appreciate these moments always. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful people of God. I'm going to take you to the book of Mark. I'll read first before I can introduce the subject that I want to deal with today. Mark chapter 2 from verses 1. We are going to go until verse 12. Okay, verse 12. And again he entered into Capernaum after some days, and it was noised that he was in the house. And straightway many were gathered together, in so much that there was no room to receive them, no, not so much as about the door. And he preached the word unto them. And they come unto him, bringing one sick of the palsy, which was born of all. And when they could not come nigh unto him for the press, they uncovered the roof where he was. And when they had broken it up, they let down the bed wherein the sick of the palsy lay. When Jesus saw their faith, he said unto the sick of palsy, Son, thy sins be forgiven thee. But there were certain of the scribes sitting there and reasoning in their hearts, Why doeth this man thus speak blasphemies? Who can forgive sins but God only? And immediately, when Jesus perceived in his spirit that they so reasoned within themselves, he said unto them, Why reason ye these things in your hearts? Whether it is easy to say to the sick of palsy, Thy sins be forgiven thee, or to say, Arise and take up thy bed and walk. But that you may know that the Son of Man hath power on earth to forgive sins. He said to the sick of palsy, I say unto thee, Arise, and take up thy bed, and go thy way unto thine house. Immediately he arose, took up the bed, and went forth before them all, in so much that they were all amazed, and glorified God, saying, We never saw it on this fashion. Wonderful. God bless the reading of his word this evening. Wow. Beautiful passage. Beautiful passage indeed. We have encounter here with the four men. This man had a man that had palsy, or I think he was paralyzed. He could not walk. And Jesus was preaching in the house. He had come and was preaching. There was a big crowd. The Bible is calling it a press. So what I'm going to talk about today is what I call creative faith. I want to challenge somebody here that you need creative faith. What is this creative faith? This creative faith, we are going to understand as we look closely at how these men went about their situation. When they realized they brought the man, there's one good thing they did. They brought the man because they wanted this man to receive healing. I want to believe there was some relationship with this man. We're not told much the relationship, but I want to believe there was a relationship. Say that maybe it was their friend or their relative somewhere. There were four of them. They came to find solution. But there were many obstacles that they faced in this in this pursuit of healing, when they came thinking that they have come to the place of solution, there were confounding factors. There were limiting factors. One of the limiting factors is that they could not access Jesus. They could not reach where he was. There was something blocking them. In this instance, it was the crowd that was blocking them. So in other words, they could not even access Jesus. They were not going to get the healing. But I want you to understand, when we talk of creative faith, I need you to understand that as we move in faith, the Bible says we have to walk by faith, not by sight. As we walk by faith, you're going to realize that situations, many situations, they will never give you a green route. They will never give you a green route. There are always situations that are opposing your cause, that are opposing your mission, that are opposing your pursuit, whatever your vision, your goals. Situations will never give you a green route. It was not just straightforward for the people, for these guys. Remember, they had already carried this man from a distance, and now they come to the place of solution. Still, there are obstacles. There are confounding factors. I'm talking to somebody here. You might have come from a long journey. You might have come from far doing something. But when you are just near the breakthrough, you're going to find that the opposition, they are confounding factors. They are opposing things there. You need creative faith. Creative faith does not just move back and turn its back and give up. Creative faith will have to find the ways to get the miracle. It has to find the way. It's a faith that never gives up. It's a faith that never retreats. When you have creative faith, you don't retreat. These men, they said, we are not retreating. We need a miracle for our friend. We are going to apply creative faith. When they realized that the crowds were blocking them, when they realized that there was no way to access Jesus, they had to think, they had to be very creative in their faith. The Bible says they had to go above the roof. You need to understand that going above the roof meant a lot of things. Number one, it was risk taking. They were taking risk because this was not their roof. This was somebody's roof. They had to do what we call risk taking. They had to take a risk in order to find their miracle. I need to speak to you, somebody here. The devil has been just stopping you. Some of you are just being easily stopped by things. When you are trying to do something, you are easily stopped by things because you are lacking creative faith. Your faith is just stopped. When they come a little test, you give up. When they come a little test, you pull back. But I need to challenge you. Let these men challenge us this evening. These men carried creative faith. You need that creative faith. They said, okay, we are not going back. We need a miracle. Oh my God. Somebody, you must just rise and say, I am not going back. I am not giving up on the business. I am not giving up on my career. I'm not giving up on my marriage. It's either I go forward or I go forward. It's either I have it or I have it. You just have to be determined. You just have to have this determination for you to receive. I need you to understand, there is need for some desperation. Desperation can also propel your faith to higher levels. It can also challenge your faith. They were so desperate. They needed Jesus' attention. And they had to go over the roof. The Bible says they begin to uncover the roof. They uncover the roof. But the Bible is very clear that when they uncovered the roof, they broke it. When they uncovered the roof, they had to break it again. And they had to bring the man down. They had to bring him down by the rope and bring the bed down and bring him to where Jesus was. I need you to understand, you need creative faith. It's a faith that when there is an obstacle, that faith will always find a way. That faith will always find a way. It's a faith that does not draw back. It's a faith that does not see obstacles as a no. They don't take obstacles as denial. They keep on pushing. You need to have creative faith. The men had to think. They had to have to create something. They had to find a way. I need you to see something. When you are pursuing your dreams, when you are pursuing your miracle, don't be easily discouraged. There are many things that will discourage you. Many people that wanted to receive from Jesus, they never had a green root. There were many say that this or that. Remember, even blind Bartimaeus, he was shouting for help, but people were saying, "You are making noise, keep quiet." But the Bible says the more they told him to stop, the more he shouted for help. I need you to understand, miracles will not just be presented to you in a silver platter. You're going to have a determination. You're going to have to be determined. You're going to have to be offensive, to push forward until you receive, until you get God's attention. Those that give up easily never receive miracle. I need to tell you, many people give up when they are at the verge of breakthrough. Many people, they let go when they are already in the zone of miracle, when they are already in the zone of breakthrough. Can you imagine? These people were already closer, a few meters to Jesus, but there were just few people that were around. When they brought him down by a rope, the Bible says Jesus saw their faith. There is a certain faith. Creative faith is faith that you can see. When somebody has got creative faith, you can actually see it because it begins to manifest. All I like something also about these people. There were four guys that were carrying this guy. I asked myself, why four? You're going to realize that there is something that we need to learn there. The number four means the number. It's a number of creation. It is in the fourth day that God finished creating what we call the material universe. The material universe was created within 4 days. So number four is the number of creation. So these men are symbolizing creative faith. The number four is a number of creation. You need to have that number four. You need to have to understand that why these men were four. It was symbolic of the creative faith. There was creative faith that was needed here for a miracle to happen. The Bible says when Jesus saw their faith, your faith has to manifest. Your faith has to be visible. It is creative faith that you can see. There is faith that cannot be hidden. You can actually tell that this is faith. You can actually see that somebody is moving in faith. You yourself, you can feel it even within you that this is faith. This is faith. You can actually feel it. Their faith was so visible. Their faith was so strong to an extent that Jesus saw their faith. And remember, faith is not just in words. Faith is in acting. These men had creative faith. It was not just faith you confess and you see it, but they had to do something. They had to make means. They have to open certain avenues. Let me tell you, there are certain doors that you're going to have to open yourself. There are doors that will be opened for you, but there are doors that you must open. There are doors that you yourself must open. You have the keys. That's why the Bible says we have the keys of the kingdom. In other words, there are doors that I must open. No one is going to open those doors for me. Even God, he will give me the key. And I have to go and open myself. These men wanted a miracle. I'm talking to you. Maybe you've been going through opposition. I need you to understand. Creative faith does not fail. It will find a way. There is a way. Creative faith is the one that made the Red Sea to part and divide. There was a way. God said to them, move forward when there is a sea before them. But God said, why are you crying? Move forward. God believes that there is creative faith. My Jesus, when Jesus saw their faith, Jesus said to the man, son, your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. There is something about, there was some grumbling that began to happen because the scribes that were there, they begin to say, what kind of man is this? Why is he saying this? This is blasphemy because he is, what kind of a man that can forgive sin? It is only God that can forgive sin. They begin to move into their theology and philosophy and all this stuff. But the thing, they didn't know that it was God that was among them. God was with them. They never realized that God was in their presence. They were seeing God. They were seeing him direct, and he was closer to them. He was wearing, if he was in the flesh, looking like them. My God, when Jesus perceived it in his heart, he said to this man, why are you grumbling about this? What is easy to say to the man, take your bed and go, or to say your sins are forgiven? I need you to understand, Jesus understood the root cause. He understood very well that it's not about the healing that you need. It's not about the breakthrough. It's about your spiritual state. The spiritual state of this man needed forgiveness. What he needed most is forgiveness. They needed to understand that certain things can come because you are not. It's because of the root of sin. Whatever you see troubling our lives, it has got to its roots in sin. Sin is the cause of all trouble. Sin is the doorway to all these troubles you are seeing. Affliction. It's all because of sin power. As long as sin power is thriving, we continue to suffer from these things. So Jesus understood the root of the matter. He understood that when sin is removed, everything else becomes smooth. When you are delivered from the power of sin, it's easy to receive your healing. When you are delivered from the power of sin, it's easy to receive your miracle. Some of the things that causes us not to receive is because sin power is still dominating. When sin is still dominating in your life, you even if you receive prayer, that prayer will be hindered. Even if somebody say be blessed, that blessing will be hindered. So Jesus understood that it's easy for us to deal with the root of sin here. Once the root of sin is dealt with, this man is going to walk free like that. My Jesus, he said, thy sins are forgiven. Need you to understand forgiveness. You need to understand that forgiveness is, he needed forgiveness. The man needed forgiveness. He needed forgiveness. Some of you here, you need forgiveness. You can't even forgive yourself. You can't even forgive others. That's why even when others, you are prayed for, you cannot be healed. Some sicknesses are there because you are lacking forgiveness. You can't forgive, and you can't forgive yourself. You can't forgive others. You are lacking forgiveness. There is no forgiveness. Forgiveness on its own brings healing. So when Jesus was forgiving this man, he was paving way for healing. You are not forgiving. That's why you're always sick. You are unforgiving. That's why you're always having sicknesses. Those sicknesses are there because you are not forgiving. You harbor so much bitterness. You harbor so much resentment in you. You harbor so much grudge in you. That's why you are sick. The sickness is caused because of unforgiveness. The man was sick. Jesus said, your sins are forgiven. The man needed forgiveness. So when forgiveness came upon the man, Jesus understood that healing will just be automatic. It will come. It will be easy for healing to find its way. Many are trying to find breakthrough. They are trying to find miracle. But we are dealing with the symptom. We are not dealing with the root cause. Jesus didn't want to deal with the symptom. The sickness of the man, the paralysis of the man was a symptom. Jesus understood that the man needs forgiveness. If he is forgiven, he will be healed. My God, may God forgive you. May you be forgiven in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus Christ brings forgiveness. May you forgive yourself. Maybe you have done something wrong. Maybe you have done something that is so bad and you are failing to forgive yourself. I need you to understand there is no unpardonable sin before God. Confess that sin before God. Tell him. Just confess it to God. Tell God about your sin. Repent and confess it. God is going to forgive you. You need to forgive yourself and move on. Because if you don't forgive yourself, that becomes an area of condemnation. The devil is going to condemn you because of that unforgiveness you have. You don't forgive others. That's why many people pray and their prayers are not answered. Because you are not forgiven. You are not forgiving. Remember the Bible says when you stand up praying. That's Mark chapter 11 verse 24. When you stand up praying, forgive. When you stand up praying, forgive. Because when you pray with unforgiveness, your prayer is going to be hindered. So Jesus said, your sins are forgiven. This is what the man needed. Jesus, as a prophet, he understood the root cause. He knew many times we go before God with wrong things. We say, God, heal my headache. But you are not having headache. What you are having is a carnal mind. A carnal mind now causes headache. Sometimes you say, God, heal me. I have got a problem. Here, I've got a problem. We are dealing with symptom. We are not dealing with the root cause. Find out what is the problem. Find out what is the problem. The man, Jesus, was very clear. He said, your sins are forgiven. He wanted healing. He came for healing. But now Jesus is talking about forgiveness of sin. That is the case of many of us. We are coming before God. We say, breakthrough, breakthrough, breakthrough. You don't need breakthrough. Maybe what you need is forgiveness. Maybe what you need is just a little kindness, love. What you need is just something that you have to do to allow the blessing of God to come into your life. We don't comprehend. We don't comprehend our requests. We don't understand the real problem we are suffering from. This is one of the biggest crises humanity is facing. Many don't know what they are suffering from. It takes the Holy Spirit actually to reveal our actual problem, our real problem. That's why Jesus does not talk about healing. He said, your sins are forgiven.
Your sins are forgiven. I declare over your life, what is the root cause of your situation? What is the root cause of your poverty? What is the root cause of your setback? What is the root cause of your disappointment? May you be delivered from that root cause in the name of Jesus. May you be delivered from that root cause in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. When this man's sin was forgiven, Jesus began to say, listen to me. This is also to show you that the Son of Man has got power to forgive sin. This is to show you that the Son of Man has power to bring salvation. Salvation, salvation, salvation. This was a question of salvation. Salvation is key. This is the biggest thing that we need above all things. The man, after receiving forgiveness, Jesus never even touched him. He just said to him, take your bed and go. Take your bed and go. Do you see how easy it became when sin power is broken? Do you see how easy it is to receive the breakthrough? When that root problem is dealt with, it's easy. That breakthrough you have been praying for years, it's easy. You just have to understand the root cause. You just have to bring the root cause before God. You just have to bring, when you pray, sometimes we are not even honest before God. When we pray before God, we pray for the symptom. We're not praying for the root cause. I pray to God and say, God, please help me. I've got this problem, but I'm not telling God that I have jealousy. That jealousy is hindering my progress. That jealousy is hindering my progress. When I have jealousy, my progress is hindered because I have jealousy. But when you pray and say, God, deliver me from greediness, you begin to see breakthrough. When you say, God, deliver me from hatred, I hate others, you begin to see breakthrough. Because what is hindering between you and your breakthrough is hatred. Between you and your breakthrough is jealousy. My God, your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. Sin power is broken. When sin power is broken, everything becomes smooth. Let sin power be broken in your life. Sin power over your life be broken in Jesus' name. That sin power, what is that sin power that is a grip over your life? Let it be broken in Jesus' name. When we're talking of sin power, we are talking of even iniquity. That sin that is following your blood, the sin that is following your family, let that sin power over your life be broken in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, glory to God. The man began to carry his bed. He was going now. He received forgiveness of sin. The foundation was forgiveness. The root was forgiveness. You need forgiveness. I perceive, many of you, you need forgiveness. Forgiveness comes when you forgive others, when you forgive yourself, when you learn to forgive. Let go. Just empty your heart right now. I know you say, man of God, that person has done something wicked in my life. Just let it go. Forgive them. Forgive them. Empty your heart right now. And you are paving way for healing. You are paving way for miracle. You are paving way for breakthrough that you need. You are paving way for progress in your life. When you forgive, when you let go of those things that happened in your life, maybe you were disappointed, maybe you were heartbroken. I can see somebody, you were heartbroken now in that relationship. Now, because you are heartbroken now, you can't move on now. Because you don't have trust now, number one, and you have that fear. It's now going to disturb you to move on and to find a proper relationship because you are now bound in that bound in that hurt that happened, that you were heartbroken. Now you are hurt, you are trapped in that situation. You must heal. You must let go of the pain. You must allow the Spirit of God to heal you. And then you are going to pave way. Jesus said, young son, your sins are forgiven. Son, your sins are forgiven. Be forgiven in the name of Jesus Christ. Be forgiven in the name of Jesus Christ. You have committed whatever. What is it that you have done? Jesus is the forgiver. He forgives our sins. No unpardonable sin. Be forgiven in the name of Jesus. Receive forgiveness in Jesus' mighty name. Receive forgiveness. Jesus pardons your sin in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, hallelujah. Father, thank you for releasing them in the name of Jesus from the grip of that sin. That sin that is standing between them and their breakthrough. That war of sin that is, Lord, causing delay. That sin power that is causing disappointment. What is causing their delay, their hindrance? Let them be delivered in the name of Jesus Christ. Release them, Lord. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you. Receive your miracle. Receive your breakthrough. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. Receive your breakthrough. receive favor, receive your miracle, receive promotion, receive healing in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive it in Jesus' mighty name. Whatever has been blocking, has been standing between you and your breakthrough, it's broken in Jesus' mighty name. God is touching you. Take your bed and go. Take your career and move on. Take your marriage and move on. Take all your business and move on. It's healed in Jesus' name. It's delivered in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You are so blessed, people of God. Thank you so much for giving me attention. Thank you so much for taking your time to join me in this service. The Lord God bless you and be with you and keep you. I'm inviting you to join us on our Sunday service at NAFCOG Auditorium in Block F. I'm there every Sunday now from 9 o'clock. Come and be with us, fellowship with us, and your life will never be the same. Otherwise, I'm back again on Wednesday here on this platform, same time. The Lord keep you and bless you. Your servant in the Lord, Apostle Lloyd Gangada. Shalom.